Mr. Ostrich. Good to see you. Hey. Hello.
Bob, how you doing, man?
Good.
Hi, oh my goodness! Hi, honey! Hi, Clint! Hi!
What's up? We had to stop into Bad Bob's and say hi to these great folks. Bought some stuff, got some cash. Now we're gonna go camping at Barefoot.
Bye! Love you guys!
Love you too!
Bye, guys!
Thanks, Bob!
Bye.
Thanks for everything you do.
So here we are, we're out in Bend, Texas. That's right, we're staying at Barefoot Campground tonight. And of course, we had to stop into Bad Bob's Bend store, say hello to him. Brandy happened to be there. We love Brandy. We met her out here a couple years ago, actually. So really cool to see her again. Maybe Melanie will be out here tomorrow. She's another one of our favorite clerks.
That's right. Stay tuned, because we got some serious camping. I got the drone. We have all our cameras. Hopefully, we get a good sunset. We might get a good sunrise. I don't know. We're in the mood to do some filming. We're in the mood to do some camping. We're in the mood to do some hiking, but there's not a whole lot of trails here. We'll try to make our own trail tomorrow.
Oh man, the air smells so good out here. Sweet. You can tell it's spring, or at least about to be.
Barefoot is a privately owned ranch. It's owned by Jackie and Charlene Brister. As a matter of fact, I think they used to live in Austin, but they're out here in Bend, Texas, like Melody said. And it's a 1,600 acre ranch, 3 miles of unscathed Colorado River. I mean, it is absolutely beautiful. We've got other videos. You should sift through our channel and try to find some of those. I'm not gonna leave links for you. We don't hold your hand. We know you're fully capable. Before we do this, we have to go through the formalities.
Jerry Ann, please take our money.
Thank you very much.
Awesome.
I enjoy the videos.
One of the things about Barefoot Campground is that we always usually come during the week, and it is during the week. Today's actually Monday, but
it is spring break.
Spring break.
Yes.
Oh yeah. So check it out.
Campers over there. Campers over there.
And campers right here.
Yeah.
That's our camp spot. We're a little cramped in here, but that's okay. It's not about being cramped, it's not about having space, it's about being outside.
I'm pretty sure we found a suitable spot for the tent. Actually, what I'm looking for is a suitable spot to sit my butt down in my chair.
Because sitting your butt down in the car for 2 hours on the way here was not enough of sitting, huh?
There was no fire.
There may still not be fire. We forgot firewood. Another state parker's signature move. Fortunately, we're not in a state park. What that means is that we are free to gather firewood off of the ground. We only use the dead stuff. There's some right there. Seems to be deadfall all around us.
Either way, this is the fire pit that we're working with. We're gonna probably reconfigure it a little bit, but we're not gonna add any rocks. I don't think that's necessary.
One of the cool features about this particular spot is that cave up there. It's a good view. I don't know if you can get in there or not. It's got graffiti in it, so evidence that there have been people in there, but I don't know if it's on this particular property. I really do think that is my least favorite part of camping right there. And I don't want you to tell us, oh, get one with a pump in it, or get one with the auto inflate. I'm not a fan of either of those. This is my favorite pad in the world, the Nemo Astro. All right, camp is pretty much set. Got the tent, got the chairs. What else?
Guess we gotta chop some firewood.
Ah, I have just the thing.
Ooh. At least we'll have fire.
Sounds good to me. It's gonna get into like the 40s tonight. It's not so bad. So we got a new piece of equipment that we haven't used. We've had it almost a year since Christmas. It's this little Ozark Trail lantern hook slash cooking tray. Since our fire pit is so deep, it'll probably work really well. It'll hang over like an A, sort of hover. And that way we can do our canned foods and our ramens and whatever else we brought. We didn't bring much on this trip. It's really not a bad place to spend spring break at. Even though there's a lot of people out here, everybody's somewhat spread out. No, none of the sites are really on top of each other. A lot of children, a lot of campfires, a lot of s'mores. Not this guy. I don't do s'mores. Too much junk food in the s'mores. But I will eat all kinds of other junk food.
It's quite a difference from what we're used to. Hearing laughter and a bunch of people, and we're not alone, that's for sure.
It really doesn't feel like Barefoot to me right now.
We usually have it to ourselves. Tomorrow should be pretty cool. We've decided to hike along the river all the way down. We'll see how many people are actually here. And who knows, we might know somebody. That's a badass Jeep. Do we even need this box?
Yes, we need it to help start our fire. See, the thing is we're not like cooking steak and pork chops on this thing tonight. We're cooking canned ravioli and lasagna. So it's gonna be really easy, but this was a really good test since we have a perfectly situated fire pit that's deep in the ground. Thank you, Dustin and William, for helping us cook our food for our campsite. Okay, it's time to get a fire started. What do you say?
Oh yeah.
Now is that weird hour at camping, especially in the full campgrounds, when you start hearing all the kids all across the land hooting and hollering like owls. I don't know what they're expecting in return or what kind of result they're looking to get, but usually one of them happens like, woo! And then 5 acres away you hear another, woo! And then 10 acres away you hear, woo! Well, we ate, and now it's time to just wind down. We have all day tomorrow out here to have activities and do some hiking, some exploring, shoot some more video. It's been a good day so far. Let's hope tomorrow's even better.
Night vision. Check.
The moon is full, and it's illuminating the ground around us, so we're not having any hard time at all trying to find our way around.
Well, the good news is we found a few more firewood pieces. Nice.
All right.
Heavy loaded.
Moving on.
Moving on.
It's about that time. So we're gonna say goodnight to y'all and see you in the morning.
Good morning, everybody. We got a bit of a late start today because we did not sleep very well last night at all.
No way.
I was having nightmares. Melody's feet were shivering. Felt like it got into the 30s, but I know it was the low 40s. Today, we're gonna go off on foot from our camp spot. There's not a whole lot of hiking trails in this park, but there's a lot to explore. So we're gonna make sure that we do that. Hopefully we run into some interesting characters along the way.
We had our breakfast, which was ramen noodles, and we've had our coffee. So I'd say it's about that time.
We decided it would be in our best interest to go ahead and take a quick trip down to Bad Bob's Ben store. Get a few more provisions.
Yeah, he closes at 6, and we don't want to be pressed for time.
Then we're going to come back, secure our site really well, and take off on an exploration type hike. Well, we got that taken care of. Resupplied, good to go. We have 1,600 acres to explore. I doubt we'll be able to show you all of it.
This is one of my favorite times of the year. The colors are just beautiful and the smell, fresh.
I agree. Colors today are just popping hard. Plenty of insects, wildlife to look at. Pretty awesome. Gotta give it to Barefoot Campground. Not a whole lot of places you can come and just freely roam around.
Dog tents, kid tents, house tents, mama tents, daddy tents.
That's intense. Some of their campsites have these shelters. They're about $7 a night. Not too bad. We've actually stayed in that one before, and we have a video about that one where we were in some severe weather and we had to make a makeshift shelter underneath. It was an ugly shelter, but it kept us relatively dry, and it was a lot of fun. I'm pretty sure the hawk is my favorite bird. Not exactly sure why, but I think they just look cooler than buzzards. And buzzards are primarily what we see around here. Not that there's anything wrong with buzzards. They're amazing for the environment. They clean up all the germs. Nature's janitors. Sometimes it's amazing who you run into out here on the trail. This particular time, we ran into Mr. Kevin Dodds.
Hey guys.
You may know him from a band called Steamroller. And another band called Funner.
Right.
And 36 other bands.
Right, a couple of others, yeah.
Yeah.
Out here, beautiful Barefoot Park or
you like
Barefoot
it?
Camp. Yeah, it's yeah. Great. It's my first time out here. It's really incredible. Just soaking this part of the river in right here is amazing.
So basically, Colorado Bend State Park is 15 miles down the river from here, and they're booked up. Completely booked up. Either that or I think they closed it actually for camping and they were doing day use only. So Kevin and his boys came out here because we recommended this place to them, and I'm glad we did.
Great place. Barefoot RV camp. Yeah, they're super nice people.
That's one of the better guitar players in all of Austin, Texas right there. Kick ass. Check them out. They're still around. Still bopping.
Yep.
Spot for us to take a little quick chill break, smell the smells, hear the flowing of the river, reflect on all the things that we've done throughout our lives, ponder the things we may do throughout our lives from here on forward.
I hope it all stays this good, if not, gets better.
I think we're talking better, baby. Found the RV park. It's on the opposite side from where we're camping. They've got running water. They have electricity. The bathrooms and showers are over here. I think it's about $20 a night. Don't quote me on that, but it's a really nice area, as you can see.
They even have smoker grills out here for them to use. Pretty cool.
Okay, well, there's your answer. I stand corrected. $25 per night for the RV section.
It is pretty cool. There's no cell service out here at all. You have to drive a few miles up the road to get it. But they have a courtesy phone here. No coins needed. That's pretty nice.
This should just simply be a cardinal rule. No perfume out in nature. I want to smell nature, not you.
So what you're saying is, you couldn't go to the restroom because it was fumigated.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Some people get dragged out here by their families. They're not campers. They're just along for the ride. They can't let go of their habits that they have at home. And it's totally understandable. But when you come out to a place like this, it's kind of appropriate to get stinky.
So we're standing in front of the Leaning Bluff Lodge. You definitely have to call and reserve this place.
It's got picnic tables on the outside, a beautiful view of the Leaning Bluff across the way. Let's go see if we can see what's inside. Unfortunately, we can't see in because it's too bright out here and too dark in there, but I can tell you that they have a giant, what seems to be like a 70-inch television. They have a full kitchen, dining room, lounge, amazing. It's really, really nice. Take my word for it.
Dishwasher. Best part about it is the coffee maker.
I have no doubt about that.
These are absolutely perfect to take with you while hiking.
Also, if you're gonna go backpacking or camping or hiking or anything and you're gonna take food with you in your backpack, bring a long spoon. It really helps to get to the bottom of those bags. And spork.
Oh my God, we got a man down! We got a man down! Call a medic! Call a medic!
How are you guys doing?
Just fine.
Enjoying this beautiful day?
Yes. We are, sir.
How awesome.
Are
you? Oh, what you got here? Battle wound?
Oh, yeah.
Just wouldn't be a State Parker's hike if one of us didn't get bloodied up and scratched all to death.
You know us.
The old group camp going on, playing some washer toss. We actually have that.
We got it for Christmas, I believe. We've played it a few times.
We played it with Andrew Sampson, my old coworker. Andrew, if you're watching this, I hope you're doing good up there in college. He's up in Northern Colorado, going to Colorado State.
That's pretty funny. That guy over there pulled up, hung his hammock, and laid right down. We're talking in a matter of 3 minutes.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that series of shots. Once again, we just had to give you another bird's eye view of how beautiful this place is, especially this time of year when everything is starting to green up, the animals are coming out. Perfect. We're gonna go try to scavenge some firewood out of some vacant sites.
Fingers crossed, those sites are still empty.
Well, we made a trip to Bad Bob's. We had to get a few more items. You know us, we always have to go to the store when we're camping because we always forget stuff. But fortunately, we were able to pick up a few items for Kevin Dodds and his boys.
There's the stuff. Food delivery.
Beautiful. You always have to forget something critical. So.
You know, it's funny you say that. We always.
Always. Always forget stuff.
Y'all having a good time?
Oh, yeah. Man, I've just been sitting here watching birds, seeing warblers and vireos.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
Rufous-sided towhee, woodpeckers, cardinals.
We've been messing with ants.
Oh, us too.
We were too. We fed them some Doritos. What's that? Ooh, that's a strike anywhere, huh?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Thank you, Owen.
We'll light our fire with this tonight.
Yeah, we will. We're going to make our hot dogs.
That's right. You guys have a great night camping.
You too, man.
Well, we're glad we were able to help them out. And thank you for the match. We're definitely going to try to use that tonight to see if we can use that to get our fire started.
The grass is so tall, it makes it a little hard to find stuff. But I found some.
The sun hasn't gone completely down yet, but it has gone down over the cliff there. So we're gonna start getting some low light and we're gonna start chilling out. We've been on our feet all day, moving, running and gunning. I think it's time to relax and do some simple camping.
And the river just looks absolutely beautiful right now. It's very calm, it's very peaceful. Hey, so what do you say we go ahead and try to start our fire with Owen's match?
Sounds good to me. I'm getting a little hungry.
Yeah, me too. Weenie?
Or eight.
Got some bread.
Hey, nicely done. Hot dogs are coming.
The red dogs are coming. The red dogs are coming. The red dogs are coming.
Did we add something to the dinner mix?
Oh, yes, we did. We've got green beans. And of course, my personal favorite, jalapeno. Thank you.
Look at the campfire smoke going across the river. That's really cool.
This is my opinion, and some people may share this opinion with me, others may not, but I think hot dogs are one way to keep it simple. They're fulfilling, they're gratifying, they're good, they taste good, some of them. And it eliminates the need to have to get all prepped and get all heavy duty with your cooking process when you're camping. Because being out in nature, to me, is all about simplicity. Yes, I say that even though we're shooting drones around, we're filming things, capturing time lapse, all that stuff. But when it comes to camping, keep it simple. That way, it's an easy breakdown, it's an easy setup, and it's enjoyable. That being said, it's really fun to have a lot of cool camping gear. But having a lot of cool camping gear, again, that means setup and breakdown. That can cut into your day. So keep it simple. And enjoy a good hot dog with your family.
How was your dinner?
My dinner was great. How was your dinner?
It was just like yours.
Well, little different. See, mine involved a spicy jalapeno.
Oh, it looks like we scored.
Heck yeah.
All right, now we're cooking.
Nice job.
Thank you, and to you as well. Right now, I'm going to see if the fire will sustain after the fat wood burns out, and then we'll throw in the color fire. For best results, simply toss 1 to 3 unopened packages on any indoor or outdoor wood burning fire. Do not cook over colored flames. Do not open packages.
It's a good thing we already ate.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, it looks like it's already working. I can see some green and some blue. Hooray for the color fire.
That wood is roaring with color. Love it. This is camping.
It's time to crawl in the tent and close our eyes. Tonight, I'm a little more prepared though. I've got my pillow, I've got my liner, and I'm gonna sleep like a baby.
The only thing weird about that is all the stories that I've been told about people with babies is that they always wake up in the middle of the night crying.
Hopefully, you don't do that.
So long as I don't have any nightmares, I guess I'll be all right.
This is going to go down in the books as one of our best camp trips of 2017 so far, if not the best. We've had a fantastic time. It was good to see Brandy at Bad Bob's. It was really good to see Kevin and his kids out here at Barefoot. It's just been a fantastic time. There's not many places that we like this much. It's kind of like home to us.
We especially want to thank Jackie, Charlene, and Jerrianne for being so kind every time we come here. Thank you.
And Jerrianne, I just want to say that was me that you were telling to slow down on the dirt road earlier. I didn't realize I was driving that fast, and I'm sorry. Didn't mean it. Won't happen again.
So until next time, he's Clint.
She's Melody.
And we are the State Parkers. Thumbs up. Follow us on Instagram. Like us on Facebook. We'll see you later. Well, it's about that time, folks. No, not bedtime. Time to get... Dang it.
Hiccup!